Can you talk a little bit about the research and production process, both for yourself in depicting that kind of trauma and for accurately depicting what is a somewhat controversial and emerging new field of therapy in sexual surrogacy?
Well, there's an incredible woman called Sue Newsom, who was a sexual surrogate and is a sex therapist, who was a huge help, and she's been an advisor on the film. So I spent many hours with her, and phone calls and emails, and Ruth and I sat with her, and she was really incredible in just telling us about the process of how that works, you know, with the client, the surrogate, the therapist, and what that dynamic is like, and telling us about the patients, the type of patients that come in and their problems, and just illuminating that field for us was hugely interesting. There's also a book that a guy called David Brown wrote, which is about sexual surrogacy. Him and his wife run, I think, the only sort of purpose-built surrogacy clinic in I think it's in North London or in one of the home counties. So I spent some time with him. I read his book. In terms of Dan, the character that I play, I mean, it's such a specific trauma that he's gone through. Really is very, very specifically horrific. So, to be honest, it was just my imagination of like thinking about that guy in those circumstances, and you know how he might react to being in a room across a table from a therapist and a female therapist, because his trauma is related to intimacy and all that. So what does that mean for him, and how would he react to that, and what would the progress of their relationship be? You know, that was really important to try and mark that progress accurately as I could imagine, you know, and in a way that, you know, one of the things I did before we shot is I sent the script to Sue Newsom, and I said I'd love you to read the script. I know you might not be au fait with screenplays, but you know, you'll get the hang of it, and could you just read it? And just one of the things I wanted to know was if she felt like the progress that they made was realistic, and she said absolutely, you know, it is. And one of the amazing things that she said was, it's incredible what happens. The hardest thing that we often find is that the hardest thing for a client or a patient is eye contact. And once somebody can make sustained eye contact and hold someone's hand and look at the surrogate and you know, in their eyes for a sustained period of time, the rest of it just spirals often, right? Not always, obviously, but which I thought was fascinating, because we take eye contact for granted, but it's the most intimate thing, right? So that was hugely helpful. So one of the things that Ruth and I worked on is at what point they finally can hold each other's eye contact and things like that, you know.